Sino sa inyo ang nakatapos na ng isang libro? From cover to cover. Ayan. So yung iba, ano, cover-cover lang muna. Sino nakadalawa? Oh, very good. May nakatatlo na ba? Tatlo? Ayan. Sige, tanungin nyo ko kung ilang libro ang tinapos ko noon in preparation for the board exam. I was able to finish more than 10 books. Actually, it's 11 from cover to cover because I never had a rest day until the day of the board examination. Anong oras kayo natutulog ngayon every night? Sarap ang buhay ng main, ha? Sige, tanungin nyo kung anong oras ako natutulog noon. So, yung usual sleeping time ko is around 2 a.m. Pero minsan ay inaabot ako ng 4 a.m. Hanggang hindi natutuyo yung mata ko, I never stop reading. And then I have to wake up at around 7 a.m. Whether I like it or not, I will like it. Kasi yung una kong makikita sa double deck ko, pagising ko, goal, top the left, 2015. Then 9 September 2015. So, you have to make a goal that will make you jump out of bed every morning. Yung pag-isip nyo, wala kayong choice, hindi mag-aral ng mag-aral. And I'm telling you guys, everything will be worth it in the end. So, anong oras kayo? Tutulog mamaya? Hindi ko naman sinabi na gayaan nyo yung ginawa ko, di ba? Kasi OA naman talaga yun. But you have to exert an extra effort, okay? Kahit additional 1 hour lang than the usual sleeping time na mayroon kayo. Basta kailangan, masanay yung mind nyo na everyday nag-a-absorb siya ng info. So, one reason siguro why I took the examination is before ako nag-take ng exam, sobrang saturated na talaga yung mind ko with info. Kasi pag hindi na kaya ng utak ko, diretso sa suso ko. So, mayroon external storage. Pero mukhang malaki yung problema ng karamihan, di ba? Walang maglalagay ng information. So, alam niyo na kung saan kayo totoong nagkulang, ha? So, doble kayo, ilaan niyo yan sa pagbabasa. Kasi actually, yung board exam, labanan mo siya ng dede, okay? Dedication sa pag-review. So, you have to give that extra effort. And sabi ko nga kanina, everything will be worth it in the end, okay? So, ayan, natapos na ba yung inyong material, yung inyong exam? How did you find the exam? Madali, mahirap? Madali na mahirap. Saan kayo mas nahihirapan? Sa Jed or sa Prof. Ed? Prof. Ed? Kaya actually, mas mahirap yung Gen Ed. Kasi yung Gen Ed, dalawa lang patutunguhan kayo dyan. It's either you know the answer or you don't know the answer. Proceed to the next question. And the next question is not related to the previous or the following question. Mahirap pigain yung utak, lalo pag konti lang yung laman. And I'm telling you guys, naranasan ko ba yan sa board exam? There are really questions na hindi ko alam kung saan ko kukunin yung tamang sagot kasi never ko siya na-encounter buong buhay ko. And it's okay, you don't have to perfect the board exam. But you have to get a hyper grading, so kailangan marami kayong kayang sagutan. Magiging madali sa inyo yung gen ed kung marami na kayong nabasa, kung malawak yung stock knowledge ninyo, matatag yung foundation ninyo. Pero pag hindi, medyo mapapanlaban tayo dito. So pag sinabi nyo na mga nahirapan kayo sa prof ed, that's also very good kasi meaning lang nun, nag-iisip kayo. Kasi diba sa prof ed, matagal kayong makasagot. So feeling nyo, pag matagal nyo nasagutan yung isang item, nahirapan na kayo kasi nga pinag-isipan nyo na yung tanong, pinag-iisipan pa pati yung options. But actually, in the end, pag chinek nyo, nahukuha nyo yung tamang sagot kahit na first time nyo lang ma-encounter yung question. As long as you master the CAR method, di ba, the test mansion techniques, kaya-kaya nyo nang iraos yung prof ed. Yung nga lang sa gen ed, hindi pwedeng ganun na, you have to memorize everything. At yan naman yung reason kung bakit kayo nasa CBRC para maging madali sa inyo, Gen Ed man yan or Prof Ed. So this day, papadaliin natin yung Gen Ed sa inyo. So I'm going to give you the actual board exam questions and competencies na lumabas na the previous seasons from September 2015 to September 2018, okay? So meaning lahat ng i-discuss natin today ay actual board exam questions na. Yun nga lang, medyo magsusulat tayo ng konti kasi honestly, hindi naman talaga natin kayang i-memorize lahat ng concepts sa loob ng 8 hours, di ba? But can you promise me by March, memorize na lahat ng ibibigay ko today? Yeah! Kapasama sa board exam? Yeah! Kapasama sa board exam? naturally. Okay, so ayan. So let's start with our first subject. We have English. Sino English major? Ayan, nakita na lang sila. Nag-shoot na iba. Okay, so we have your English. And our first competency there is vocabulary. Sino sa inyo mayroong problema sa vocabulary? It's okay. I also had the same problem when I took the examination. There was a question that goes like this. How is original and primary forest referred to? Okay, pag sinabi natin original or primary forest, the trees are untouched, the trees are uncut. So the choices are letter A, green forest, letter B, rain forest, letter C, virgin forest, and letter D, verdant forest. What do you think is the correct answer? So yun din yung inisip ko ng time na yun, mga virgin forest to. Pero napariwara ako kasi hindi ko alam yung meaning ng word na verdant. So yung iniisip ko noon, baka yung verdant mas fit doon sa context ng original and primary forest. So in the end, I answered verdant forest. Kasi yung virgin parang tulog bastos, yung verdant parang tulog matalino. Siyempre doon ako sa tulog matalino, diba? And after the exam, hinanap ko yung meaning ng verdant sa dictionary. It only means luscious green. And I lost 0.4. Yung lamang sa akin ng top 1 during my batch is 0.2. And that is one of my greatest regrets, that I did not improve my vocabulary. Because I could be the top 1. Pero syempre, tapos na yun, wala na akong magagawa doon, di ba? Pero kaya ko siya kailangan ikwento sa inyo because I want you to learn from my mistake. You have to improve your vocabulary, okay? Ang problema natin, paano? So, syempre, ang nag-iisang reviewer ninyo, pag sinabing vocabulary, is your dictionary. Pero hindi nyo pwedeng aralin yung buong dictionary, di ba? Vocabulary pa lang, kumatos ka na. So, paano ba yung ibang competences? So, ganito yon. May app kayo sa phone nyo, yung Merriam-Webster. Tapos may games yan, di ba? Name the thing, true or false, and how strong is your vocabulary. Laruin ninyo yung how strong is your vocabulary. Sa dami ng actual board exam questions na na-encounter ko, karamihan sa mga words na nandun, andun din sa app na yun. So meaning, this time, limited na lang ang kailangan ninyong aralin. And actually, hindi nyo naman namamalayan na nag-aaral kayo because you are having fun at the same time you are learning. Yun nga lang, may dalawang problema tayo doon. Number one, baka hindi nyo maalala yung mga words na nilalaro ninyo. Or number two, hindi kayo makaalis sa level 1. Di ba? So, paano pag hindi pa rin talaga siya ganun ka-effective? Okay, so I'm going to teach you the techniques kung paano nyo i-approach ang isang vocabulary question. So, let's start with your question number one. She has a vision of feminine concretude. The capitalized word means? What is the capitalized word? You have the word concretude. Okay. Now, ang tendency kasi, di ba, pag vocabulary question, saan kayo naghahanap ng context clue? Doon sa question mismo, sa sentence, di ba? Pero, ang problema natin, yung sentence na to, maiksi lang siya. So, ang tendency, pag maiksi din siya, walang masyadong context clue doon sa question mismo. So, kung hindi nyo pwede pag-isipan yung question, pag-isipan ninyo yung options. Okay? So, punta kayo doon sa options. And then, you can do this. You do the positive, negative. Okay? Let's try. You have the word homeliness. Is that positive or negative?
Positive.
Meaning, mabahay na yung itsura mo. So, positive or negative?
Negative.
How about the word loveliness?
Positive.
Plain. Pagkaraniwan.
Negative.
Ugliness.
Negative.
Anong word yung naiiba? Yung word na loveliness. And it's not an accident na siya yung naiiba. May purpose yun. Because that is the correct answer. Okay? So, anong gagawin natin doon? You do the positive, negative, positive, negative. Kung anong naiiba, that is the correct answer. Okay? Pag sinabi kasi natin yung concrete, so it means beauty. So, that is the same as loveliness. Pero hindi applicable yung positive, negative sa lahat ng question. Okay? Just like your question number two. My concept of inner peace came from my mother's daily activities, which I now recall with fondness and awe. She was a full-time housewife, fully dependent on my father's monthly salary.
How she made bold ends meet guided us in our studies and did small acts of charity on the side was beyond me. The mother's financial resources are. So, ang problema natin sa question na yan? Ang haba naman ang question, di ba? So, sa actual word, hindi nyo gustong pag-isipan lahat ng context clue na nandyan, okay? So, anong gagawin natin? Pag hindi kayo pwedeng mag-isip, doon sa question mismo, pag-isipan naman ninyo yung options, okay? And another technique is this, maghanap kayo ng word na antonyms, okay? Maghanap kayo ng antonyms. Pag may nakikita na kayong antonyms dyan, automatically, one of them is the correct answer, okay? Basta may antonyms, one of them is the correct answer. May nakikita ba kayong antonyms?
Yes.
Ano yung mga words na yun? You have the words abundant and limited. Okay, so meaning, tanggalin mo na yung more than enough, tanggalin mo na yung miserable, doon ka lang mag-iisip sa abundant and limited. Tapos may sinabi siya doon, how she made bold ends meet. Anong ginawa niya? Pilit niyang pinagkakasya. Pilit niya ng pinagtatagpo. So kung pilit niya ng pinagkakasya, ang kanyang resources, is that abundant?
No.
Or is that limited?
Yes.
Yeah. So what's the correct answer? That is limited. Okay? Pero yung technique ulit na yun, hindi applicable sa lahat ng question, just like this question. Wala siya sa inyong material, pero nasa board exam. Okay? Question, William Shakespeare showed composure in front of his critics amidst countless duration. The underlined word means. What is the underlined word? You have the word? Composure. So yung hinahanap natin dyan is yung word na synonym ng composure. Now, you look at the options. Letter A, you have the word agitation. Pag sinabing agitation, naiintindihan nyo ba siya? Like, di ba agitated, di ba nagwawala, nangiligalig, galit na galit. So that is showing irregular or violent movements. Okay? Letter B, you have the word fear. When you say fear, that's takot, di ba? Being afraid, being scared, being worried. Letter C, you have the word of mom. Is that familiar to you? Is that a word you encounter every day? No, so just leave that, never mind. Okay, and letter D, you have the word nervousness. Oh, kasi sinabi nervousness, magkapa, di ba, nervous. So that is showing the feeling of being afraid or being worried. Now, ano nga ulit ang competency na mini-measure sa inyo ng PRC for that question? Mini-measure ng inyong vocabulary. So tingin nyo ba, ibibigay sa inyo ng PRC for vocabulary yung mga words na nervousness, yung words na fear, yung words na agitation? No, hindi nila ibibigay sa inyo for vocabulary yung mga words na familiar sa lahat. So in short, ang ibibigay nila something unfamiliar or difficult. And in that case, what word is not familiar to you? The word of home. And that is the correct answer kahit hindi nyo alam ang kanyang meaning, okay? So anong technique natin doon? Hanapin nyo yung mahirap na word that is the correct answer, okay? So, kasi hindi naman kayo bibigyan ng vocabulary word na familiar naman pala sa lahat, okay? Pero pag sinabi yung aplomb, it means being calm, being gentle in times that you are in a difficult situation. So in short, that is showing composure, okay? So yun ang ating mga techniques. So ulitin lang natin. Number one, anong gagawin? You do the positive, negative. Kung anong naiiba, that is the correct answer. Another technique, maghanap kayo ng antonyms. One of them is the correct answer. And the last one, hanapin na lang yung mahirap na word. That is the correct answer. But aside from those techniques, ang pinakamasarap na feeling, mag-exam ka na alam mo na exactly kung ano yung mga words na lumalabas, di ba? So I have here the sets of words na lumabas na the previous season. So just take note of this and try to know the meaning of the following. If you know the answer, just give me the answer, okay? So first one, you have the word abes. Abes means demoted. Kabalitaran siya ng promoted. Meaning, bumaba yung kanyang rank. Okay, so abes is demoted. Okay, yun na po. Okay, next one. You have the word despotic. Ang tanong niya sa board exam ganito, which of the following should not describe a father? Okay, which should not describe a father? Letter A, head of the family. Letter B, superior in the family. Letter C, patriarch of the family. Letter D, despotic. Bakit despotic? Yun lang yung hindi familiar sa inyo, di ba? So the correct answer is despotic. It means cruel. The father of the family should not be cruel. Okay, so that's despotic. Okay, next one. You have the word persiflage. Persiflage. Ayan. Yung word na yan, lumabas yan sa mga BEED. Sino palang BEED dito? Ayan, so medyo marami tayong BEED. Upang BEED, gawag lang na mag-expect na madali yung gen ed ninyo, okay? So it's going to be difficult for you kasi yan na yung pinaka-majorship ninyo. Di ba kayong mga elementary teachers, jack of all trades kayo eh, di ba? So kailangan alam ninyo bawat subject ituro. Yun nga lang, pagdating sa actual world, sobrang lalim ng tinatanong nila. Ginagawa nilang majorship level ng bawat subject. So medyo magbasa-basa lang kayo ng mas malalim. So, Gen Ed, don't worry, the same competency pa rin yung iniikutan ng mga questions. Yun nga lang, pinapalalim nila. For example, pag BSF gaya mga tanong sa inyo, sino ang first Philippine hero na nag-defy sa presence ng Spaniard sa kanyang land? Sino ang first Philippine hero natin? Si? Lapu-Lapu. Yung first Philippine hero si Lapu-Lapu. Pero pag mga BSF gatanong sa inyo, gaano kahaba ang bahag ni Lapu-Lapu? Ang problema nyo na yun, di ba? So, ganun yung level ng question. Like, parang hindi ka pwede makampante na alam mo na na it's Lapu-Lapu. So, alamin nyo pa yung ibang details. Anong nangyari sa kanilang imagina, anong meron sa kanilang encounter, okay? So, pag BSN, okay na yung memorize na ng who, what, where, when. Pero pag BEN, pati yung how and why, alamin nyo na din. Kasi minsan, iniikot lang nila yung tanong, okay? Pero doon pa rin yan, iikot sa mga competencies na i-discuss natin. Oh, for example, yan yung word persiflage, medyo hindi talaga siya familiar. So, it means to praise glowingly. Parang nag-joke ka sa kanya lightly. Okay, so that's persiflage, to praise glowingly. Okay, next one. We have the word dexterity. Pag sinabing dexterity, ano yung na-associate nyo? Yes, yung hand, di ba? So it has something to do with the hand. So it's a manual skill. It's a manipulation of the hand. It's a manual skill. So that's dexterity. Okay? How about the word amorphous? Amorphous, from the word morph, meaning morph is form, di ba? Shape. So, siya naman, amorphous, meaning no form, no shape, that is shapeless. Okay, no form, no shape, that is shapeless. Okay, so yan yung mga examples of words na lumabas sa BEED. Ito naman, BSN naman tayo. Tingnan ninyo, medyo familiar siya sa inyo. Okay, first one, you have the word penchant. Penchant is? No, fondness. Okay, penchant is fondness. She has a penchant for red accessories. Penchant is fondness. How about the word? Pulgritude. Pulgritude is? Loveliness. Sulat na naman nila yan, di ba? Ito na nga, question number one. Goal ninyo, mapagod kayo, okay? So, pulgritude is loveliness, okay? How about the word? Transmuted. Yes, change. The figures must be transmuted first in order to understand the grades. Transmuted is change. May kumukha siyang word, transcend, transcendental. Transcendental is supernatural, like unexplainable. Okay, so transcendental, that is supernatural. I'm sorry. Okay, transmuted is change, transcendental is supernatural. Okay, next one. You have the word rancor. Rancor is?
Bitterness.
Bitterness. Rancor is bitterness. Kaya pag nabibitter kayo, huwag kayo mag-post na, I feel so bitter right now. Okay, ano sasabihin nyo? I have so much rancor in my heart. So, nakapag-emote na kayo, matalino pa, diba? Pero huwag kayo sabay-sabay mag-post na. Alam tayo masyado. So, Valentine's, pare-pareho na kayo ng post dyan. Okay, so rancor is bitterness. Okay, now, next one. I have the word carnal. Carnal is worldly. Meaning makapundong pananasa. Carnal. I am designed to satisfy a man's carnal arousal. So carnal is worldly. Okay. Next one. Mundane. Like mundane. Just this thing. Ano yan? Mundane is ordinary. Mundane is ordinary. She is easily distracted by mundane things. So mundane is ordinary. Okay, next one yung the word profanity. Yes, profanity is obscenity, meaning kalaswaan. Okay, the program was suspended because of profanity. So yung profanity, yan yung never nyo matututunan dito sa CBRC, diba? So profanity. The next one yung the word apocalyptic. Prophetic. Magatunong sila, okay? Apocalyptic, prophetic. Apocalyptic, prophetic. Pero paano pag ang tanong ay ano? Apocalypse. Prophecy. Ano mo? Apocalyptic, prophetic. Pag apocalypse, prophecy. Okay, so ganun siya. Next one, you have the word impertinent. It means? Not, diba? So it's not related, not relevant, that is irrelevant. So M is not related, not relevant, that is irrelevant. Okay, next one. You have the word loquacious. Loquacious is verbose, meaning talkative. Okay, verbal, masalita. So that's verbose. Pag walang verbose, anong hahanapin sagot? It's talkative. Okay, loquacious, verbose. How about the word voracious? Voracious. Someone who is very eager. Okay, voracious is very eager. Ang tanong dyan sa board exam ganito, Clara would read any book that her hands could lay on and read it from cover to cover in one sitting. She is a blank reader. The answer is voracious. So very eager siya kasi binasa niya from cover to cover. So that's very eager. How about the word abandon? Familiar na yan sa inyo. Hindi na familiar, naranasan nyo pa, di ba? Abandon is left behind. Okay, abandon, left behind. Okay, abandoned, left behind. Ang tanong dyan, the patients were abandoned by the relatives. So that is left behind, okay? How about the word conflagration? Conflagration is a large fire. It's a large fire. So pag may sunog, anong isisigaw ninyo? Conflagration. Siyempre, sunog na lang masisigaw nyo yan. Kabado-kabado lang kayo, di ba? Masusunog, na-arty-arty way. Conflagration, conflagration. So, paano kayo i-rescue? Tutulungan, di kayo naiintindihan, di ba? O, ayun. Conflagration is a large fire. Na-arty mga tao dito. Next one. Yan, the word of law. Oh, sulat na naman nila kanina ba yan? Hindi yung upload. Composure, di ba? Upload is composure. Nung nalabas daw yan isang season, wala doon sa option yung composure. Ang nandoon ay relax. Pwede ba siyang isagot? Yes, kasi composed, kalmado, relax, pareho lang din sila, okay? Next one, volition. Volition is your? Yes, will. That is your power to make choices, okay? Volition is your will, the power to make choices. Okay, next one, you have the word esoteric. Esoteric means understandable by few. So there are topics that only a group of people could understand. Okay, so ang tawag doon ay esoteric, understandable by few. Okay, esoteric, understandable by few. But how about the word Q? Q is line, okay? It is a line of people waiting for something. Q is line. Kaya nga tinawag siya ng banana Q kasi naka-line yung banana, di ba? Barbecue, naka-line yung Barbie, okay? So Q is line, okay? Next one, you have the word baduy. The term baduy about? Yes, awkward looking. Baduy is awkward looking. So it's a local color. Baduy is awkward looking. Hey, how about the word docile? Docile, tracy, catorce, kinchi, misteri, so ano yan? Docile is easy to manage. Manageable, parang ganun, okay? So docile, that is easy to manage. Okay, docile, easy to manage. Next one, you have the word euphoria. Euphoria is a state or a sense of well-being. Di ba pag sinabi niyo for your extreme happiness niya, di ba? Ecstatic happiness. So that is a state or a sense of well-being. So yan yung dyan is well-being. Okay? Next one, you have the word erudite. Erudite. Nalilingin na siya somewhere. So divergent, di ba? May faction na erudite. Sila yung Although talino, so that is learned. Okay, so erudite is learned. Intelligent. Okay, so that's erudite, learned. Okay. And then last time, naging trend din actually sa board examination, yung mga French terms at Latin terms. Okay, so try nyo nasagutan yung sumusunod. You have sine qua non. Ano meaning ng sine qua non? It's a Latin term. It means indispensable, meaning very important. Sine qua non, that is indispensable. Okay, ito naman, French term naman, you have the word? Sorry. I'm so sorry. yeah, that's soirée. Okay, it's a French term, soirée. It means evening party. Okay, soirée is an evening party. So then, I'm so sorry. Okay, next one, you have the word connoisseur. Connoisseur. French term ulit siya. He is someone who is expert in matters of taste. Okay, so critic siya sa food, sa wine, okay, basta taste. Tricky word. Expert in taste. That's your connoisseur. Kahit yung taste lang, tandaan ninyo, ayan. Expert in matters of taste. So parang food critic siya, wine critic, that's connoisseur. Okay? Next one, you have the word chauffeur. Chauffeur is a French term for? Driver, yes. Pinasosyal lang yan, chauffeur lang yan sa atin, di ba? Pinasosyal nila. So, pag sasakay kayo ng jeep mamaya, ano sabihin nyo, chauffeur, chauffeur, wait for me. Okay. So, chauffeur is a French term for driver. Okay. So, next one, you have the word madam. Madam is a plural of? Yes, madam. Pag sinabing madam, isang babae lang siya. Pag madam, maraming babae. Kaya nga, miss, damis, madami, miss. Kasi nga, maraming babae. So that's madam, the plural of madam. Okay, so French term ulit siya. Okay? Ito, alam niyo to. Renaissance is blanc in French. Yes, rebirth. Okay, renaissance, that is rebirth. Renaissance, that is rebirth. Okay, ayon sa kakalabas na ng question na to, you have the word a cappella. Ito options niyo: solo singing without accompaniment, without accompaniment, without music, without accompaniment. Without accompaniment pa rin. Kasi pag without music, hindi wala na kayo narinig. So without accompaniment, ang nasa isip nyo, without music, kal instrument. Yun yung nasa isip nyo, di ba? Meaning, wala siya accompaniment. So that's a cappella without accompaniment. Okay? And then you have the term, makalabas namin ito, alter ego. Alter ego. So ito yung mabibilian ninyo. Is it a self outside the body? Or is it a close and inseparable friend? Self or friend?
Friend!
Iba pong sinabi parang ego, it has something to do with your personality, with yourself. So yun yung unang mong iisipin. Pero ang dictionary meaning yan ay close and inseparable friend. So someone who knows you very well, parang other half mo na siya, okay? So that is a close and inseparable friend. So that's your alter ego. And you close your notes, practice tayo, okay? Give me the word as I give you the meaning. Loneliness. Fondness. Eagerness, demoted, praise glowingly. Sige, open your notes na ulit. Open your notes na ulit. Hindi nyo naman kailangan i-memorize yan lahat ngayon, di ba? Siyempre, kung nabili kayo sa kusulat-sulat, tapos alam na naman memorize nyo. Walang pressure dito, okay? But promise me, by March, memorize nyo lahat ng yan, ha? So, kung binalikan mo kayo, pag tinanong ko, wala nang ano, ha? Wala nang gagawin. So, wala na din mag-open ang mga simple ano, okay? So, by March, kailangan memorize nyo na lahat yan, okay? Next one, you have phrases and statements. Okay, pwede mo nyo na isulat to kung familiar naman sa inyo. Naging trend kasi last time din yung mga French phrases or French quotations and then mga Latin phrases, Latin quotations. Okay, so try lang ninyo sagatan yung mga sumusunod. Ano ang meaning ng amor con amor sepaga? Ano lang naintindihan yung word dyan? Amor. Ano amor is? Love. Now, ilang beses binanggit yung Omar? Dalawa. Mag-isip kayo ng sentence or condition na dalawang beses binanggit yung love. Love begets love. So, kaya-kaya niyo pa rin makuha ang tamang sagot. Kasi nga, nakita niyo, dalawang amor. So, that's dalawang love. Okay? Love begets love. Okay? Next one, you have caveat emptor. Caveat emptor. So, it's a Latin phrase. Ginagamit naman siya sa business side. Caveat emptor, meaning let the buyer decide. Okay? Caveat emptor, let the buyer decide. So, pag may binili kang isang product, choice mo na yan. Okay? So, ikaw na bahalang mag-check ng kanyang quality and everything. So, caveat emptor, let the buyer decide. Okay? How about the word ad nauseam? Ad nauseam. So, meaning yan, sumusobra na siya up to the point na nakakasuka na. So, ganun siya sa Tagalog. Parang nakakasuka na. So, it is sickening to an excessive degree. Excessive degree meaning sumusobra na siya kaya na siya nakakasuka. Okay? So, that's ad nauseam. Okay? Next one, you have coup de grace. Coup de grace? Coup de grace. Coup de grace. So that is death blow. Okay, coup de grace is death blow. So it's a form of penalty, it's a form of punishment, it's a French term again. Okay, coup de grace is death blow. Okay, so yan naman ang mga phrases and statements na binigay nila. Alas na konti na lang to, we have your correlation. Ang correlation, ang madalas lumabas niya competency na yan sa mga BEd, okay? Ang mga tanong nila, which two words lack correlation? Ano daw ang dalawang words na walang relationship? Actually, madali lang naman i-identify kung mayroon silang relationship or wala. Nagkaka-problema lang tayo dyan pag hindi niya naiintindihan yung meaning ng mga words na nandun sa options. So, although marunong kayong tumingin ng relasyon, pag hindi niya naiintindihan, mahirap pa rin kunin yung tamang sagot. So, para maging madali yung buhay nating lahat, kinolektor na lang namin yung mga actual word exam question, tapos kinuha na namin yung sagot. So, sagot lang yung i-memorize ninyo. O, nakita niyo to, shade na kayo agad. Okay, so number one, yung mga prodigy and offspring. Ayan, prodigy and offspring. O, sinabing prodigy, someone who is talented. Okay, ang offspring naman, anak. So, wala din siyang definite relationship. Prodigy and offspring. Okay, nakuha po. Next one, you have formally, unconventionally. Formally, unconventionally. Mas sinabing unconventional, not traditional. So, wala din siyang relationship, formally, unconventionally. Okay, next one, you have formerly and heretofore. Formerly, heretofore. Pag formerly, nangyari na siya sa past, di ba? Pag heretofore naman, sa present. So, actually, antonym sila. But then, the rest of the options doon ay synonyms, kaya siya pa rin yung correct answer. Siya yung walang relationship. And then you have ready and at the same time. Ready at the same time. So wala din kaming mahanap na definite relationship sa kanila. Ready and at the same time. And the last one, you have specie and variety. Specie, variety. Pag sinabi yung specie, it should be the same. Okay, pag variety naman, it's different. So wala din silang relationship. Antonyms kasi sila. So specie and variety. So yan na lang yung mga natatandaan ninyo. Ano ang hahanapin yung tanong sa inyo pag ganyan? Which two words lack correlation? Wala silang relationship. Okay? At pwede na kayong mag-rest ng very light. Proceed to your next question. You have number 3. In William Shakespeare's Merchant of Venice, Portia the judge said, the quality of mercy is not strained. It droppeth as the gentle rain from heaven upon the place beneath. It is twice blessed. It blesseth him that give and him that takes. 'Tis mightier than the mightiest, and one is likened to God when mercy seasons justice. The main talk of that excerpt is that. So yan ang tinatanong sa atin, ano daw ang main talk na excerpt? Okay, emphasize na muna natin, sino ang nasulat ng Merchant of Venice? Si William Shakespeare. Okay, and then may sinabi siya doon, ang mercy daw, para siyang gentle rain from heaven. Saan na kinumpir ang mercy? Sa gentle rain from heaven. Using that comparison na ang mercy ay parang gentle rain from heaven, i-interpret natin yung mga options. Number A, mercy is only for the deserving. Yung ulan ba mayroong pinipili? Like hindi ka deserving o basa, lahat sila basa na ikaw na lang ang tuyo. Pwede ba yun? No, pag-uulan, dami-dami ba yung lahat? So mali yung letter A. Mercy is limited in extent. May limit ba ang rain? Wala. Di ba nga, when it rains, it pours. It floods. Pwede din, it floods. Okay. So, meaning, wala siyang limit. Palit din yung letter B. Okay, letter C. Mercy is spontaneous and freely given. Ano meaning spontaneous? Tuloy-tuloy. Naturally occurring. Ang rain ba ay tuloy-tuloy? Yes. Libre bang magpaulan? Yes, kaya hindi libre magpadelay kasi magkaiba naman. No. So tama yung it is freely given. Okay, and the word mercy comes from the rain. O, literal naman masyado yung interpretation, di ba? So therefore, what is the correct answer? That's letter C. Mercy is spontaneous and freely given. So yan ang patandaan ninyo sa Merchant of Venice. Okay, now, recall lang natin yung inyong yung literature kasi mapasok tayo sa world literature. Pero kung kayo magsulat dito, familiar na sa inyo yung mga terms na to. Mas marami kayong isusulat later. Okay, so I have heard the types of literature, prose and poetry. Now, sabihin niyo na sa akin kung siya ay prose or poetry. Alin sa dalawa ang isinusulat by paragraph? Prose. Pero ano yung bilinay, patuluntun? Poetry. Ano yung gumagamit ng formal, casual na words? Prose. Ano yung mga artistic yung ginagamit na words? Poetry. Ano yung kailangan tama yung grammar? Prose. Ano yung okay lang mali-mali yung grammar? Poetry. So, ito na yung pinakamadaling distinction. Pag poetry, malaya ka dyan, okay? So yung priority mo is yung art, okay? Basta maging maganda siya basahin, maging masarap siya pakinggan. So okay lang kahit mali-mali yung grammar mo kasi yung priority mo is maging artistic siya. So yan yung poetry. Pero pag prose, medyo formal yung approach natin, okay? And I have your examples of prose and poetry, okay? Masimula lang tayo sa prose. Number one is novel. Pag sinabing novel, mahaba, maiksi. Mahaba. Pero siya ay dinidivide sa ano? Chapters. So, anong keyword natin for novel? It is chapters. It is a lengthy story divided into chapters. Okay, next one, you have your short story. From the word itself, short, di ba? Paano nalaman na short lang siya? Yes, kaya mo siyang basahin in one sitting, di ba? Kaya mo siyang basahin ng isang pasada lang, okay? Tapos na kaagad, may wakas na agad. So, very simple lang usually yung kanyang plot. So, that is a short story. Next one yung place. Pag sinabi yung place, mahaba, maiksi.
Mahaba.
Pero siya ay dinidivide saan? Yes, sa acts or scenes. Divided into acts or scenes. So, anong keyword natin sa place? Acts or scenes. Pero pag novel, anong keyword natin? Chapters. Okay, next one, you have legends. Legends are stories that tells the, anong keyword? Legends, the origin of something. Diba? It tells the origin of something. Like, malakas at maganda sa legends. Okay? And then you have fables. The stories sa kwento ng kahayupan. The stories whose characters are animals. And teaches what? Yes, moral lesson. And teaches moral lesson. Tanong, anong tawag sa famous collection ng fables? Aesop's Fables. A-E-S-O-P. Okay, Aesop's Fables. And then we have essay. So essay, as long as my opening, my body, my conclusion. Okay, you give your view, your idea, your opinion. That's an essay. And then we have anecdotes. Ang anecdotes, saan lifted yung story? sa real life, di ba? Of real people. So, totoong buhay yan ng tunay na tao. Yun nga lang, edit pareho na sila ng biography. Kasi ang biography, yun din ay real life of real people. Now, anong pinagkaiba ng anecdote sa biography? Ganito yun. Ang anecdote, one incident lang. Okay? Isang pangyayari lang siya sa tunay na buhay ng tao. Okay? Pero pa sinabi natin biography, ikwento, simula nung pinanganak ka, ano yung ginawa mo habang ikaw ay nabubuhay, hanggang sa ikaw ay namatay. So meaning, it is a complete story, okay? So ano yung one incident lang? Anecdote, pero a complete story, that is your biography. For example, yung gamugamo at gasera sa buhay ni Jose Rizal, anecdote, biography?
Anecdote,
okay? Pero paano yung Rizal's life, works, and writings? Biography. Nakuha ang difference? Pag ikaw mismo nasulat ng story mo, ano tawag? Autobiography. Autobiography. Okay, next one, you have news. News is your current events. Okay, so latest happenings. And syempre, we have oration. Oration is a public speech. So it's a speech you deliver in front of an audience. So yan ang halimbawa natin ng prose. For poetry naman, divided sila further into three categories. You have narrative, lyric, and dramatic. Tanong, alin sa kanilang tatlo ang nag-detail ng story?
Narrative.
Kasi nga, narrate. No? So that's narrative. Ano yung intended to be sung? Intended to be sung is lyric. So yung mga songs natin, it is a lyric poem. Kaya nga siya tinawag na lyrics ng kanta. Because it is intended to be sung, okay? And ano naman yung intended to be performed? Dramatic. So dramatized, that is dramatic, okay? Ano yung nagtawag ng story?
Narrative.
Ano yung intended to be sung?
Lyric.
Intended to be performed? Dramatic. Okay, now, pasok na tayo sa totoong laban. You have the masterworks of the world. So, ibibigay ko sa inyo yung kanilang title. Sabihin nyo sa akin kung sino yung tao na tinutukoy ng sumusunod. If you know the answer, just give me the answer. Okay? If you don't know the answer, I will give you clues. If you still don't know the answer, I will give you the answer na. Basta just try answering the questions na muna. And then, pwede nyo i-shortcut yung notes na yun. Okay? Number one, sino father of printing? Yes, Johann Gutenberg. Okay, so father of printing is Johann Gutenberg. So printing Gutenberg. Okay, printing Gutenberg. Okay na ba? Hindi pa, sige. Ito, medyo familiar siya sa inyo. Sino ang father of English essay? Yes, Francis Bacon. Father of English essay is Francis Bacon. I'm sorry. Okay, next one. Sino, nalang ninyo ba nakita kanina? Sino ang greatest English writer? William Shakespeare. Greatest English writer, William Shakespeare. Greatest English writer, William Shakespeare. Okay, pero minsan kasi ang tinatanong nila dyan, hindi yung greatest English writer, nawawala to, pinapalitan siya na sonnet. Sino ang greatest sonnet writer? Sonnet. Same answer, William Shakespeare. Pag walang greatest English writer, ano nga hanapin? Greatest sonnet writer, we have the same answer, William Shakespeare. So, piname, pakatanong sa inyo, greatest, sino sagot? Si William Shakespeare. Sino naman ang dubbed as the bard of Avon? Avon, siya talaga naka-discover ng mga lipstick, baka yan siya, si William Shakespeare. So, bali, tatlo na yung title ni Bakla na tatatandaan ninyo, okay? So, ano si Bakla? Greatest? English writer? Ano ba greatest? Sonnet writer at bard of Avon. O, sino sagot doon? William Shakespeare. O, ito kilala nyo din. Sino ang father of English literature? Yes, si Geoffrey Chaucer. The father of English literature is Geoffrey Chaucer. the father of English literature kasi noong time nila siya lang yung gumamit ng medium na English. Okay, so mostly Latin yung ginagamit nila. Kaya siya naging father of English literature. Pero paano pag walang father? Ayan, paano pag walang father, anong hahanapin ninyo? Yung morning star. Sino ang morning star of English literature? The same answer, Geoffrey Chaucer. So the father and the morning star of English literature is Geoffrey Chaucer. Father and morning star. Ito, kilala nyo din. Sino ang father of horror stories? Yes, horror stories, Edgar Allan Poe. So yung kanyang mga story, yung character, nililibing ng buhay. Okay, so it's all about mystery. So pag horror, you answer, Edgar Allan Poe. Paano pag walang horror? Anong hahanapin ninyo? Pag walang horror, yes, hanapin nyo yung detective. Sino father of detective stories? Same answer, Edgar Allan Poe. Kasi nga sa kanya ay mystery. So horror detective, that is Edgar Allan Poe. Okay, next one. Sino ang foremost French short story writer? French? Guy de Maupassant. Hindi kayo magkakamali dyan. Sa option, si Maupassant lang yung apelyado na ang dating ay French. Okay, so the foremost French short story writer is Guy de Maupassant. Lagay nyo lang dyan, French. Okay, next one. Sino naman ang mythical geographer who was recognized due to his vivid description of geographical landmarks? Sino daw? Homer. Okay, so mythical kasi hindi proven yung existence ni Homer. Wala talagang nakakakilala at nang magpatunay na nag-exist siya. Okay, kaya siya tinawag na mythical. Pero po sinabi natin Iliad and Odyssey, sino pa rin yung nire-recognize natin for that? Si Homer pa rin. Kahit isa lang siya myth. Okay, next one, greatest orator of the world. Yes, orator is Cicero. The greatest orator of the world is Cicero. Greatest orator, that's Cicero. Tapos may isang greatest pa na tinanong, ano daw ang greatest lyric poem of the world? Greatest lyric poem, nababasa nyo yan sa Bible. Yes, the Psalms of King David. The greatest lyric poem is the Psalms of King David. Greatest lyric poem, the Psalms of King David. And then, aralin naman natin yung inyong mga naging Indian writers. Sino ang Indian national poet? Indian national poet? Initials niya ay R.T. Rabindranath Tagore. Indian national poet, Rabindranath Tagore. Tandaan nyo, siya ang first Asian to receive a Nobel Prize for Literature. The first Asian to receive a Nobel Prize for Literature, that is Rabindranath Tagore. Sino naman ang Shakespeare ng India?
Kalidasa.
Shakespeare ng India, Kalidasa. May Shakespeare ng India, that is Kalidasa. Mahilig din kasi siya masulat ng play tulad ni Shakespeare. And syempre, do not forget your philosophers, Aristotle, Plato. Pag hindi nyo na sila maalala, tsumpaa. Okay, anong ginawa nila? Na-tsumpaan sila. Sino unang tsumpa? Italis. Sino ba Italis si? Socrates. Sino ba ni Socrates si? Plato. Sino ba ni Plato si? Aristotle. At sino ba ni Aristotle si? Alexander the Great. Anong ginawa nila? Hindi may ginawa si Namotino. Anong ginawa ni Thales? Anong ginawa ni Thales? T-H-A-L-E-S. He replaced myth with natural law. So anong keyword sa kanya? Natural law. THALES, that's Thales of Miletus, okay? Natural law. Si Socrates naman was best known for the Socratic method. So, ang tanong sa pag-exam ganito, what is true of the Socratic method? You write Q&A. Ano Q&A? Question and answer. Ano tinuro sa atin ng Socratic method? The art of questioning, okay? Ano niya Plato, the author of the Republic? Plato, the Republic. Okay, Plato is the Republic, okay? And then Aristotle naman is biology. He was best known for his contributions in biology, Aristotle, biology. And Alexander the Great. Alexander the Great is a great conqueror. Di ba pinagsigas siya bilang mananakop? Okay, so he is a great conqueror. O sige, ulitin na natin. Sino yung conqueror?
Alexander!
Sino yung biologist?
Alexander!
Sino yung the Republic? Question and answer. Sino ang natural law? Sino ang bard of Avon? Sino ang greatest orator of the world? Ano ang greatest lyric poet? Sino ang greatest English writer? Sino ang greatest sonnet writer? Sino father of English literature? Sir, Morning Star? Sir, French? Critical geographer?
Homer.
Father of printing?
John.
Grabe ng Bray, okay? Kasi ninyo, luwari yun, nanonood naman sa notes nila. Okay, buhay, pero tumitingin sa notes. Okay, sige. Next one, I have here the famous authors and their works, yes?
Meron pong example about sa debate, yan po yung mga choices.
Okay.
Sa ano yun? Sino po yun?
Sa debate? Are you questioning? Pwede si Socrates to add a question. Sa anong subject niya sa English natin? Hindi ko kasi pwede na yan.
May tanong ko kasi doon ma'am sa ano?
Sa ano?
Sa prof-ed before.
Ah, sa prof-ed.
Na debate po yung ano.
Sa prof-ed po yung ano. Tapos,
choices.
Sino daw yung nagpaano ng debate? Parang gano'n. Ah, okay. Hindi ako ganun ka-sure because I don't teach Raphael. Pero, yun, di ba pag debate is arguing, so questioning, so Socrates ay yes. Sino sabi ko sa inyo? Ano ba sa group? Tanongin ako? Para to sa lahat ko. Yan, i-clarify na nga natin sa mga researchers ninyo for Prof. Ed, okay? Para sure tayo. Kasi hindi tayo pwede mabigay dito ng info na hindi naman pala sure. Hindi pwede yung I think lang kasi may talagang answer key na ibibigay yung PRC, okay? So, tanongin ko na lang, tapos pa-announce natin next meeting na. Talaga ako, kala ko na reklamo kayo dyan din yung marinig yung mga sinasabi ka dito. Sabihin na lang natin sa RA ninyo, ha? Pa-research natin sa inyong ano, academic team for Prof. Ed, okay? So, ayun na po. So, let's, this time naman, bigay natin yung mga famous authors and their works. So, ibibigay ko sa inyo yung title ng kanilang isinulat, okay? Sabihin nyo sa akin kung sino yung nagsulat, okay? So, eto, lumabas siya dalawang season na nasunod-sunod. Sino daw ang nag-deliver ng Gettysburg Address? Kailan niyo yan? Gettysburg Address, si Abraham Lincoln. Okay, Gettysburg Address, that is Abraham Lincoln. Okay, next one. Kakalabas lang ng question na to noong September 2018. Sino ang nagsulat ng Dr. Zhivago? So, B.E.N. din lumabas. Dr. Zhivago is a Russian writer, Boris Paternak. Okay, so Dr. Zhivago, that is Boris Paternak. Ang pagkakatanong dyan last time, pabaliktad, ano daw ang isinulat ni Boris Paternak about totalitarianism rule in Russia? Okay, totalitarianism rule in Russia. So the answer is Dr. Zhivago. So lagay yung malito. Yung tao na nasulat si Paternak. Okay, pero yung title lang kanya isinulat, Dr. Zhivago. So he is a Russian writer. Okay, Next one, this is question number 1 noong September 2017. Sino daw ang nagsulat ng Scarlet Letter? Scarlet Letter, si Nathaniel Hofer. Okay, Scarlet Letter, that is Nathaniel Hofer. Okay, Scarlet Letter, that's Nathaniel Hofer. Okay, eh, pakilala niyo to. Lumabas siya sa leadership ng English. Sino nasulat ng Harry Potter? Yes, J.K. Rowling. Okay, Harry Potter is Joanne Kathleen Rowling. So, leadership naman niya ng English lumabas pa yung mga Chronicles of Narnia. Okay, next one. Paradise Lost. Paradise Lost was written by the blind poet of England. Blind poet of England. Kaya nga, lost yung kanyang paradise kasi hindi niya na makita. J.M. Yes. J.M. de Guzman. John Milton. Okay. Saan na masama sa J.M. de Guzman dyan? Okay. Paradise Lost is John Milton. Okay, next one. You have The Little Prince. The Little Prince by Anton de Saint-Exupéry. Mahaba yung kanyang pangalan. So, Exupéry lang yung tandaan ninyo. Kahit Exupéry lang, okay na yan. Hindi naman mismod yung PRC. Hindi naman nila nilarambol yung mga tanong. Tsaka yung options. Wala naman doon options na William Chaucer. Okay, mga Edgar Allan Exupéry, di ba? So, Exupéry, edition na yun. Okay? So, Anton de Saint-Exupéry. Okay? Anong itinuro sa atin ng Little Prince? Hanapin niyo yung ano, only the heart can appreciate the beauty of life and love. Okay, so yung nakaka-appreciate daw ng beauty and love ay yung heart. Kasi ano sabi niya doon, it is only with the heart that one can see rightly. What is essential is invisible to the eye. So hanapin niyo yung life and love. That's the teaching of the Little Prince. Okay, next one, Uncle Tom's Cabin. Uncle Tom's Cabin by Harriet Beecher Stowe. Uncle Tom's Cabin by Harriet Beecher Stowe. Okay, so Uncle Tom's Cabin. And then may tanong last time, ano daw ang hinihinala nila na nag-trigger ng civil war sa US? Ano daw ang nag-trigger ng civil war sa US? So that is Uncle Tom's Cabin. Kasi siniwalat niya yung state ng slavery doon sa US. Okay, next one, you have Canterbury Tales. Yes, kay Geoffrey Chaucer. So, siya ay kwento naman ng pilgrimage or paglalakbay nila hanggang sa Canterbury. So, ang Canterbury Tales kabilang yan sa 12 most influential books of the world. Okay, next one, you have the word. You have the title, Analex. Kanina yung Analex. Kay Confucius. Pero hindi talaga si Confucius yung nagsulat niya. Kasi never niya isinulat yung kanyang teachings. Okay? Nung namatay si Confucius, kinolect na kanyang mga students yung kanyang witty sayings, philosophies, and wisdom. Tinawag nila ang compilation na The Analects of Confucius. Kaya pag tinanong kayo, kanina ina-attribute ang Analects, ang sagot pa rin ay si Confucius. And then may tanong doon, sino daw ang hindi religious leader? Sino ang hindi religious leader? The answer is Confucius. Pero ang spelling ng name doon is Confucio. Di ba siya din naman yun? Confucio, Confucius. Okay, so hindi siya religious leader. He is more of a philosopher. Okay? And then, Annabel Lee. Yes, Annabel Lee by Edgar Allan Poe. Pero ang tanong last time, baliktad, ano daw ang isinulat ni Edgar Allan Poe that shows his grief over the death of the woman that he loved? Okay, shows his grief over the death of the woman that he loved. So that is Annabel Lee. Love life siya ni Edgar Allan Poe. Namatay na lang, okay? And then we have The Raven. Same answer, Edgar Allan Poe. So The Raven, that's Edgar Allan Poe. Okay, so yan ay ilan sa famous works na sinulat ni Edgar Allan Poe, The Raven, and Annabel Lee. Pero makakita yan, okay? Next one, The Necklace. Kay Guy de Maupassant. Naalala niyo yung kwento sa libro natin nung high school, yung babaeng tanga-tanga na peke pala yung alahas, di ba? Pinagbayaran niya buong buhay niya. So that's The Necklace by Guy de Maupassant. Your foremost, ano yung word? French short story writer. Okay, next one, you have Macbeth. Okay. Ano yung Shakespeare, okay? Yung mga Christ naman ni Shakespeare, sobrang sikat na kasi siya. Kaya yung ginagawa nila doon, hindi na nila tinatanong kung sino yung nagsulat. So ang tanong nila, tungkol saan? For example, saan daw sinabi ni Shakespeare na ang overwhelming ambition for power, that's your keyword, power is the cause of downfall of man. So pag power, you answer Macbeth. Okay, pag power, you answer Macbeth. Okay? And then, to be or not to be is the opening statement of Hamlet. But to be or not to be, that's the opening statement of Hamlet. It's still written by William Shakespeare. Pero saan sinabi ni Shakespeare na ang mercy ay parang gentle rain from heaven? Mercy? Merchant of Venice. Okay. But mercy, that is your merchant of Venice. Mercy, merchant. Mercy, that's merchant of Venice. Okay, it's now written by William Shakespeare. Oh, ito, lagi na itong lumalabas. This is a story of two ill-fated lovers from warring families. Love and War, that is Romeo and Juliet. But Love and War, that's Romeo and Juliet. Okay, Love and War, that's Romeo and Juliet. Oh, sige, ulitin natin. Ano yung power? Hamlet. To be or not to be? Hamlet. Okay, ano yung mercy? Merchant of Venice. Pag Love and War, Romeo and Juliet. Okay, next one, Chronicles of Narnia. Chronicles of Narnia, si Carl S. Lewis. Okay, Carl S. Lewis. Okay, or C.S. Lewis lang yan minsan, di ba? C.S. Lewis, Chronicles of Narnia. Pero may sumagot naman lang ng Aslan. Si Aslan yung layon, okay? Di man siya ang nagsulat, okay? Chronicles of Narnia by Carl S. Lewis. Okay, War and Peace. War and Peace, it was written by the Russian writer L.T. L.T. Leo Tolstoy. Okay, so War and Peace by Leo Tolstoy. War and Peace, Leo Tolstoy. Siya din ang nasulat ng God Sees the Truth But Waits. Okay, si Leo Tolstoy. And then we have Rubaiyat. Rubaiyat was written by Omar Khayyam. Okay, Omar Khayyam. Tinatanong dyan actually, hindi yung nasulat, kundi yan ito. What is the general theme of Rubaiyat? Ano daw ang tinuturo sa atin ng Rubaiyat? Sabi niya, Carpe Diem. Ano meaning ng Carpe Diem? Seize the day. So meaning, you live life to the fullest. That is, grasping pleasure while you can. At may sinabi siya doon, you eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow you will die. So ano ang priority ng Rubaiyat? Yung pleasure. Kung may nabasa kayo related sa pleasure, you answer Rubaiyat. That's grasping pleasure while you can. And then you have Divine Comedy. Kahit pangalan niya lang ang maalala nyo, Divine Comedy is the repeated Dante. Okay, Divine Comedy, Dante. Dante Alighieri, Divine Comedy, that's Dante. Meron lang dyan, Dante. Okay, Divine. Kasi minsan ang nakalagay lang doon, Dante lang. Okay, Divine Comedy, that's Dante. And last one, sino nasulat na? Giranjali. Giranjali. Yes, Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, so Rabindranath Tagore. Yan yung kanyang pinanalunan ng Nobel Prize for Literature, yung Gitanjali, which is the collection of song offerings. Okay, Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, so this time naman, pasok tayo sa mga famous writings. Don't worry, konti na lang to. Okay, so ito yung mga isinulat na nagkaroon ng impact sa ating world literature. So pag familiar na sa inyo, huwag nyo nang isulat. Okay, like, ano daw ang first epic ever written sa buong mundo? What's the first epic ever written? Number G? Yung mga goblin. Gilgamesh. Okay. Gilgamesh. The first epic ever written sa buong mundo is Gilgamesh. Okay. First epic ever written, that's Gilgamesh. Okay. Next one. Ano naman ang Egyptian system of writings? Egyptian. Hieroglyphics. Okay. So Egyptian system of writings, that's hieroglyphics. Anong ginagamit nila dyan? Nagtudraw sila ng pictures sa mga walls, sa bricks, sa pyramid. So Egyptian, that is hieroglyphics. Pero paano pag hindi Egyptian yung nandoon? Paano pag yan ay Chinese? Ano ang Chinese system of writing? Chinese, that is calligraphy. Okay, Chinese system of writing, that is calligraphy. Pag Chinese, that's calligraphy. So pag Egyptian, anong sagot? Hieroglyphics. Pag Chinese, that is calligraphy. Okay? And then, ano yung collection of stories? Isa siyang Persian literature. Kasama dyan yung Alibaba and the 40 Thieves, Aladdin and the Magic Lamp. Yung every night siyang nagkikwento para hindi siya ilapatay ng hari. Tapos eventually hindi na siya pinapatay. Oo, yung may Arabian Nights, A Thousand and One Arabian Nights. A Thousand and One Arabian Nights. Okay? So eventually hindi na siya pinapatay ng hari. Okay, so naging collection na tuloy siya ng stories. Kasi nga every night meron siyang kwento. Okay, so that's A Thousand and One Arabian Nights. So eto, alam na alam niyo to. Ano ang longest epic of India? Mahabharata. Oh, sulat pa naman nila yan. Okay. Longest epic of India is Mahabharata. Kaya nga, mahaba kasi longest. Okay? Epic of India, Mahabharata. Pero nasawa na sila sa question na yan. Kaya last time kong tinanong, ano daw ang medieval German epic? German. Pag hindi nyo mapronounce German yan? Di ba hindi nyo mapronounce? So German yun. Neben, Ongen, Light. Kayo nga? Basta pag hindi nyo na-pronounce German yan, okay? Never, long, get light. Tandaan nyo na lang, may knee sa unahan, may light sa dulo. Okay, so that's your medieval German epic. Never, long, get light. Okay na? O, ano nga ang longest epic of India? Barata. Anong medieval German epic? Okay, next one. Anong collection of Indian sacred hymns? So, lagay niyo lang hymns. Rig Veda. Okay, collection of Indian sacred hymns is Rig Veda. Lagay niyo to. Ayan o. Hymns ng hymns, that is Rig Veda. Sacred hymns, that's Rig Veda. Okay, pero ano naman ang tawag sa collection of Indian sacred texts? Okay, collection of Indian sacred texts. Pag text lang, that is Upanishad. Okay, pag sacred text, Upanishad. Lagay niyo lang dyan text. Pero careful lang kayo, magamukha yung question. Okay, so collection of Indian sacred. Pag hymns, ano sagot? Rig Veda. Pag text, ano sagot? Upanishad. Kaya basahin mo buti yung tanong kasi magamukha sila. O, last one, anong collection of Indian fables? Indian fables? Indian. Letter P. Letter B, Panchatantra. Okay, collection of Indian fables is Panchatantra. Collection of Indian fables, that's Panchatantra. Okay? Ano nga ang longest epic of India? Mahabharata. Medieval German epic? Okay, ano ang first epic ever written? Gilgamesh. Ano yung Egyptian system of writing? Hieroglyphics. Pag Chinese? Calligraphy. Ano ang collection of Indian sacred hymns? Rig Veda. Pag sacred text? Upanishad. Pag collection of Indian fables? Panchatantra. Collection of stories? Upanishad. Upanishad. Yung iba. Nabawasan. Pinapakay agad siya ng hari. A thousand, a hundred, a thousand, and one. Arabian Nights. Okay, last na to, pen names. Tatlo na lang to, don't worry, tatlo na lang. Okay, so, ang dami kasi nating writer na gumamit ng pen names, pero syempre, hindi lahat ng yun problema ninyo. Okay, so eto lang yung mga lumalabas sa word exam. Sino si Mark Twain? Sino si Mark Twain? Samuel Langhorne Clements. Okay, so pag tinanong kayo, sino nagsulat ng Adventures of Tom Sawyer at Adventures of Huckleberry Finn na walang Mark Twain? Sino sagot? Si Samuel Langhorne Clements. Okay, next one. Sino si George Eliot? Yes, Mary Ann Evans. Babae yan siya. Noong panahon kasi ni na Mary Ann Evans, hindi ina-acknowledge yung works ng mga babae. So yung ginamit niyang pen name ay panlalaki. Para mabasa pa rin ng society ang kanya isinusulat. So George Eliot is Mary Ann Evans. Okay? At sino si Robert Galbraith? Masikat siya using her real name. Siya ang famous author ng Harry Potter. Si J.K. Rowling, okay? So, Robert Galbraith is Joanne Kathleen Rowling. Okay, so yan naman yung mga pen names na kailangan maging familiar kayo. Okay, and pwede na kayong magpahinga ng very light. So, pasusunod. So, our next competency is Mood of the Line. So, hindi na kayo magsusunod dito. Sabayan nyo na lang ako sa pag-interpret. So, eyes on the screen. Okay, so question. What emotion or feeling is expressed in this line? To be or not to be? That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer, the snakes and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of trouble and by opposing and them. Okay, saan ninyo makikita yung line na yan? Saan siya makikita? Sa Hamlet. Ano nang bigay sa inyo na siya ay nakikita sa Hamlet? To be or not to be. At actually, dyan pa lang sa first line, mayroon na tayong sagot. To be or not to be. Anong nangyayari sa kanya? Hindi siya makapag-decide kung to be or not to be. So what's the correct answer? That is indecision. Hindi siya makadecide kung to be or not to be. The answer is indecision. Next one, wala siya sa inyong material, pero na sa board exam, so eyes on the screen. Daylight, I must wait for the sunrise. I must think of a new life, and I mustn't give in. When the dawn comes, tonight will be a memory too, and a new day will begin. What is the mood of the night? Hopeful? Motivated? Ito siya stay? Ng boses ko, ano nasagot ng iba? Debated, di ba? Naging enthusiastic. Oh. Alam niyo yung pakiramdam na hindi kayo kayang ipaglaban? Huwag niyo iparamdam dyan sa option, ha? Pinago ko lang yung tono ng boses ko, palit kayo akaagad. Eh, kanina lang, sure na sure, agad kayo na hopeful yan, di ba? O sige, magbigay kayo sa akin ng keywords na nagsabi sa inyo na hopeful yan. Go! Yan o, oh, sunrise, ano ba, new life, mustn't give in, new day will begin. Lahat na nga, di ba? Ang tinutukoy niya ay hope. So the correct answer for that is hopeful. Okay, oh, another one. So this stanza was lifted from Acquainted with the Night by Robert Frost. Okay, ano sabi niya dyan? I have been one acquainted with the night. Pag sinabi natin night, ano yung na-associate niyo na feelings? Positive or negative?
Negative.
Ang paggabi, masaya or malungkot?
Malungkot.
Depende sa sitwasyon. Kung may kasama ka, masaya, di ba? Pero kung mag-isa ka lang, malungkot. Ang sabi niya dyan, I have been one acquainted with the night. So mag-isa lang siya, siya ay malungkot. Okay? I have walked out in rain, back in rain. Pag tayo ay naglalaro sa ulan, masaya or malungkot?
Masaya.
Masaya. Pero anong ginawa niya? Nag-walk out siya kasi nga siya ay malungkot. Okay? I have walked out the farthest city tonight. Pag tayo ay naglalakad, na alam natin yung ating destination, saan ka makakarating? Doon sa destination mo, di ba? Pero saan siya nakarating? Sa farthest city light. Kasi in the first place, hindi niya talaga alam kung saan siya pupunta. Okay, so now, anong feeling ang nangingibabaw sa ating speaker? Positive or negative?
Negative.
Now, look at the options. Letter A, isolation and loneliness. Positive or negative?
Negative.
Joy, getting out of the house. Positive. Youthful delight, playing in the rain. Positive. Happiness, in having been acquainted with the night. Positive. Anong naiiba? Okay, isolation and loneliness. So the correct answer is A. Isolation and loneliness, yan ang negative. Okay, next one. Though nothing can bring back the hour of splendor in the glass, of glory in the flower, we will grieve not, rather find strength in what remains behind. Okay, so ano sabi doon? Rather find strength in what remains behind. Ang speaker ba natin ay positive or negative?
Positive.
Kasi sabi niya, find strength in what remains behind. So that's positive. Now look at the options. Grief, positive, negative.
Negative.
Hope, positive. Loss, negative. Despair, negative. Anong naiiba yung hope? So that is the correct answer. It's hope. It's the only positive. And proceed to your next question. Manolo approached the platform with his speech. His palms were sweaty and his hands were shaking. He felt the palpitations of his chest and perspiration began to appear in his forehead. Manolo is experiencing epilepsy. Ah, hindi yung epilepsy? Ah, kasi nagpalpitate yung kanyang chest, diba? So that is heart attack. Hindi rin. Ano sagot nyo?
Stage fright.
Confirm this is push. Oh, hindi na kayo makutaka ngayon. Okay, so what's the correct answer? That is stage fright. Kasi doon pa lang sa first sentence, may sagot na, he approached the platform with his speech. So meaning, he is going to deliver a speech in front of an audience. At ano nararamdaman natin pa ganyan? Siyempre, that is your stage fright. Okay? At ang stage fright, yan yung kauna-unahang fear na kailangan ninyong makonquer. Pag nakuha nyo na yung license ninyo, pag mataas ang naging board rating ninyo, dahil pwede kayong maging lecturer sa CBRC, lalo pag naging inspiring din yung journey ninyo. Okay? Pero syempre, hindi namin kayo isasalang hanggang mayroon kayong stage fright, diba? So yung inyong mga faculty, nagkaroon niya ng kanya-kanyang baptism. So kahit ako din, nagkaroon ako ng baptism. Tapos yung nag-baptize sa akin, si Sir Carl mismo. So yung ginawa niya, meron siya speaking engagement sa Bicol. Around 3,000 siguro yung kanyang audience. And then that day, tumawag siya sa akin. Sabi niya, ayan, may gagawin ka ba tomorrow sa office? Sabi ko, wala naman po masyado, sir. Sabi niya, sige, sumunod ka sa akin dito sa Bicol kasi guest speaker ako bukas ng isang student congress. Tapos gusto ko, may special appearance ka lang. Kasi nung time na yon, nasabing pa yung virality nung naging journey ko sa board examination. So, nag-travel ako nung gabi. Habang nasa bus, tinawagan ko siya. Sabi ko, sir, may kailangan mo ba akong i-prepare na speech or whatsoever? Sabi niya, ah, wala. Ako nang bahala sa'yo. Basta ganito yung drama natin bukas ha. Pag tinawag ko na yung pangalan mo, tumayo ka lang. Tapos, kumaway ka lang sa kanila. Sabi ko, sir, sa mga oras po yung biyahe ko dito sa bus. Sure po kayo, yun lang yung role ko. Tumayo lang, tapos kumaway lang sa kanila. Kaya oo, ako nang bahala sa'yo. And then, natulog na ako buong biyahe. Tapos, kinabukasan, no, magkasama na kami, sabi niya, oh, dyan ka lang sa tabi ko kung saan ako upo, dyan ka din. Tapos, sumingit na kami sa maraming tao hanggang sa nakarating kami sa presidential table kasi nga siya yung guest speaker. Tapos katabi namin doon lahat ng mga university presidents sa buong Bicol region. Nung tinawag na si Sir Clark para magsalita, naiwan ako mag-isa. Kinausap ako ng isang president. Sabi niya, sekretary ka ni Sir Clark? Sabi ko, ay hindi po. Tapos si Sir naman, speech na siya. Ini-inspire niya yung mga bata. Sabi niya, do you wanna be a top dancer? Do you wanna be like her? Watch her story. So, pinay nila yung video ko ng TV Patrol. At di ba may part doon na umiiyak-iyak yung tatay ko. So yung mga president sa tabi ko, iyak-iyak na din sila. Sabi nila, ang swerte naman ang magulang ng bata na yan. Tapos yung isa, kinausap ako. Sabi niya, ang inspiring ng story niya, no? Sabi ko, oo nga po eh. Yung imagine ako po yan eh, diba? Kasi nga, wala pang no signal eh, sir. Tapos na natapos yung video, sabi niya, please welcome the viral top catcher herself, Miss Aya Serespi. O siyempre, pagtawag sa akin, tumayo ako, tapos kumaway. Tapos tinawag niya ako sa gitna, naramdaman ko na may mangyayaring masama. Malapit ko, sabi niya, mag-speech ka. Sir, sabi niya kagabi, hindi ako mag-speech. Mag-speech ka. Sir, hindi ko po alam yung sasabihin ko. Sabi niya kagabi, hindi na ako gagawa ng speech. Mag-speech ka, bahala ka na kwento mo yung buhay mo sa kanila. Tapos iniwanan niya ako sa gitna, hawak-hawak yung microphone. So imagine yung 3,000 na tao naghihintay magsalita ka, di ba? So wala akong choice, mag-speech ako, umabot ng 30 minutes. Tapos pabalik ko doon sa upuan, sabi ng president sa akin, ikaw pa na yun, kanina ka pa namin pinag-uusapan dito, hindi naman ako nag-imigla. So yun yung kaya sila sa akin, kasi narinig ko talaga lahat ng comments nila sa pamilya ko. And then nung magkasama na kami ni Sir, sabi ko, sir, bakit niya po ako titraitor? Di ba tinawagan pa rin magagabi? Sabi niya, eh kasi pag sinabi kong gagawa ka ng speech, gagawa ka talaga ng speech. So paano mo makakamper yung stage fright mo? So parang realize ko, ay oo nga no, nawala na naman yung hiya ko. So very thankful ako kay Sir Carl, ginawa niya yun. Pero hindi sa lahat ng oras nakakatuwa siya, di ba? Alo o 3,000 yung mga audience doon. Kaya guys, pag kayo sinabihan ni Sir na, uy, ano, naging inspiring din yung journey ninyo. Upunta kayo dito, kaway-kaway lang kayo sa mga estudyante. Huwag kayo maniwala sa kanya. Ginawa na agad kayo ng speech, okay? At yan ang tinatawag natin na stage fright, okay? Pero yung iba sa inyo, tawa-tawa lang yan. Pero then inside, galit na yan kasi gutom na siya kanina pa, di ba? Over the meantime, you may take your short break and then we will resume in a few minutes. Hello. Ayan, okay na kayo guys? So let's continue our discussion. Our next competency is grammar and sinabi niya yung grammar, di ba? May mga sinusunod tayong rules, okay? But don't worry, simple lang naman yung mga tanungan pagdating sa grammar and correct usage. Sige nga, i-recall lang muna natin yung inyong parts of speech. I have here the parts of speech, and then ibibigay ko sa inyo ang kanilang definition. Sasabihin niyo sa akin kung anong part of the speech ang dinedefine ko. Ready? Okay, anong tawag sa name of places? Place, person, noun. Anong ginagamit in replacement of a noun? Pronoun. Okay, anong ginagamit natin to describe a noun or pronoun? Adjective. Anong nag-state ng action or being? Verb. Ano naman ang nag-describe sa verb or adjective? Adverb. Ano nag-show ng relative possession or relationship? Preposition. Ano nag-join sa words or phrases? Conjunction. Ano nag-express ng strong feeling or emotion? Interjection. Okay, di ba madali lang siya? This time naman, bibigyan ko kayo ng example of words. Sabihin niyo sa akin kung anong parts of speech. Ready?
Yes!
Okay, listen.
Verb!
Yes, ano ka? Listen? Verb! Nakilig na kayo. Okay. O, ano listen? It's a verb, okay? Ano yung flower? Beautifully? Adverb. Beautiful. Adjective. Okay? Ano naman yung in, on, at?
Position.
And, or, but?
Conjunction.
He, she, they. Oh my. Interjection. Tama naman, he, she, they. Pronoun, oh my, interjection. Okay, iba na rin ulit lang. So, oh my is interjection. Sige. Actually, ang naging problema na natin dyan ay ang inyong preposition. Ang tamang gamit ng inyo, in, on, and at, diba? So, dyan na rin kayo naan natin actually. So, practice lang ulit natin. Recall natin yung gamit ng in, on, and at. Okay? So, Jerome's family lives na sa Luzon Street. Sige, alamin nyo muna natin yung gamit ng in, on, and at. So, natutunan yung gusto ko makita sa notes ninyo, mag-draw kayo ng inverted triangle. Okay, inverted triangle. Tapos, i-divide nyo siya into three parts. So, pinakamalaki, ilagay nyo yung in. Sa gitna, ilagay nyo yung on. Sa pinakamaliit, ilagay nyo yung at. So, yan ang gusto ko makita. Inverted triangle. Sa pinakamalaki, may in. Sa gitna, may on. Sa pinakamaliit, may at. In, on, and at. Tapos na po yung triangle nyo. Yeah. Iba kasi isang buong page ng notebook, isang triangle, diba? Okay, kahit maliit lang, basta ka siya, in, on, and at. Now, anong nilagay nyo sa pinakamalaki?
In.
Tapos sa gitna?
On.
Sa pinakamaliit?
At.
So, kaya yan nandiyan kasi yun din yung gamit niya. Okay? So, for example, ginagamit natin yung in. Diba ang pinag-uusapan natin, malaki, malawak, something broad, something general. So pag general, anong ginagamit?
In.
Pero pag lumiit, naging specific, ang ginagamit ay on. Pag lumiit palalo, naging very specific, ang ginagamit na ay at. Okay, nakuha yung rule. Pag general, anong gagamitin?
In.
Pag specific?
On.
Pag very specific, at. Sige, practice tayo ha. Let's talk about places. When I say Philippines.
In.
The Philippines. Luzon.
In.
Luzon. Malawak yung Luzon. Manila.
In.
Manila. Rojas Boulevard.
On.
Ayala Avenue.
On.
Ipil Street.
On.
533 Ipil Street. Tower 2, Unit 1952, San Jose, Texas. At, so, ganito yun. Tandaan nyo na lang yung on, doon kayo magmarka sa gitna, okay? Yung on, kasi siya yung nasa gitna. So, meaning, mas magiging madali i-adjust yung in at, tatandaan nyo na lang yung on. Ginagamit yung on, pag ako yung nag-uusapan natin, mga daanan. Ano ba yung mga daanan? Streets, boulevard, avenue. Okay, so baka pinagdaanan natin, ang pinag-uusapan natin ay daanan. Ano sagot ninyo?
On.
And anything na mas malawak sa daanan, just like your city, municipality, province, region, country, anong gagawin ninyo? In. Okay? Pagdaanan na lang. On. Pero pag yung daanan, nilagyan pa ng number. Mas naging specific. 533-8-3 yung answer. At. Or yung exact address ng bahay nyo, yung answer. At. Or pag wala nang ibang tinutuhoy na location, kundi yun na lang mismo yung answer. At. Naintindihan po ang places. Okay. Now, let's talk about time. When I say 21st century.
In.
Okay. When I say 2019.
In.
January.
On.
In January. First week of January.
On.
The first week of January. Monday.
On.
We will have a meeting at Monday.
On.
Monday. 9 o'clock in the morning.
At
5 p.m. So, ganito yun. Tandaan nyo ulit yung on kasi siya yung nasa gitna, okay? Ginagamit natin yung on pag ang pinag-uusapan ay weeks and days. Yun ang gamit niya, weeks and days. For example, on the first week of January, okay? On Monday. So, pag weeks and days, anong ginagamit natin?
On,
okay? And anything na mas malawak, so weeks and days, just like your month, years, 5 years, decade, century, anong gagamitin?
In.
Okay? Pagka weeks and days na lang, anong gagamitin?
On.
Pag oras mismo ang binigay, yun yung ginagamitan ng at. Okay? Pag oras na lang ang binigay, you answer at. Okay? Next one, you have your means of transportation. Okay? Means of transport. Ang sagot lang dyan palagi, in or on. So, means of transportation. Halimbawa, airplane.
On.
Jet plane.
On.
Train.
On.
Bus.
On.
Jimmy. Tricycle. Van.
On.
Okay, ganito yung rule. Kapag nagkakatayo ka pa, you are going to use on. Pag hindi ka na makatayo, you are going to use in. Ang tatandaan nyo dyan, di ba may kanta? I'm living on a jet plane. Okay, nakakatayo ka ba sa jet plane? Yes, kanina na akong trip mo, magpasok mo, nakaupo ka na agad, di ba? Pero pwede naman tumayo muna. So, pag jet plane, anong sagot ninyo?
On.
Kasi nakakatayo ka pa. Pag hindi na, anong sagot?
In.
Anong tatandaan? I'm living on a jet plane. Now, sige, practice tayo. When I say airplane.
On.
Jet plane.
On.
Train.
On.
Bus. Jeepney. Yan ang sagot ng on unan mo. Yun, okay? So, pag jeepney, di ba kung mag-anong-anong na kayo, di na kayo cash ka. So, pag jeepney, anong sagot?
In.
Tricycle?
In.
Van? In. Okay. Yun nga lang, nagka-problema ako dyan last time. Nag-lecture ako sa Kidatawan. May isang estudyante, kahit anong turo ko, na pag jeepney nga, ang sagot ay in. On pa rin talaga siya ng on. Eh, lahat ng classmates dyan, nag-gets na yung rule. So, hinayaan ko na lang siya kasi ang dami bang kailangan i-discuss. Tapos nung break time, lumapit siya sa akin, nagpa-picture, hanggang dito ko lang, unando pa na siya. Kaya naman pala sagot siya ng sagot ng on doon sa gymnay. Kasi nga, nakakapayog naman talaga siya sa gymnay, di ba? So ako yung may mali doon, ginudge ko masyado yung bata. Kaya hirap maging judgmental minsan, di ba? Pero guys, kapag ganun kasi, pag-question, hindi naman alam ng PRC kung unando ka or hindi. So yung gagawin mo, yung general rule lang sa sagot mo, di ba? Kung ano yung general rule ng grammar, so wag mong i-apply kung ano yung sitwasyon mo. Diba? Pero I was really wrong that time. Okay, tama naman siya. Nakatayo kasi siya. So, ang sagot ay on. Pero ang tatandaan nyo, yung I'm living on a jet plane. Okay? Next one, you have delivery of the message. So, ang ginagamit natin ng medium, pwedeng printed media, pwedeng electronic devices. So, anong gagamitin ninyo pag printed? In or on?
In.
Kasi may word na in sa printed. Okay? So, you use in. Pag electronic, ano gagamitin?
On.
Kasi may word na on sa electronic. Okay? So, pag printed, ano gagamitin?
In.
Pag electronic, ano gagamitin?
On.
Naintindihan yung rule. So, yeah, practice tayo. The message was delivered using letters.
In.
Journals.
In.
Computer.
On.
Fax machine.
On.
Diaries.
In.
Newspaper.
In.
Telephone. Cell phone. Very good. Let's answer the question. Jerome's family lives in San Basho. Street. 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 Kaya kayo nag-aaway. Walang tamang sagot. The answer is Okay. Pwedeng in, pwedeng out. Kasi nga, wala tama sagot. Ang sagot na siya is straight. The answer is, oh, don't worry, pinakailaman na namin yung option para sure tayo na kaya niyong ipaglaban yung gamit ng in, on, and out. Sa actual word, may on na yan. Ito, oh, yung two on talaga yan. Okay. So, anong tama sagot? It should be on, in, on, out. So, the answer for that is on. Dahil ang pinag-usapan natin ay is great. Okay, the next one, you have the rules of subject-verb agreement. Okay, isa din po sa ayaw natin, kasi pag sinabi natin rules, di ba, may kailangan tayong sundin. And we have more than 20 rules, actually, pagdating sa subject-verb agreement. But don't worry, hindi kailangan lahat ng yun memorize ninyo. So, eto na dapat yung alam nyo. Practice lang tayo. I'm going to give you the statement to tell me the verb na gagamitin. Ready? Okay, the frog jumps. The frogs jumps. Okay, so ganito. Para walang magkamali, para safe kayong lahat, just answer jump. Kahit ano yung tanong, just answer jump. Pag na-realize ninyo na dapat mayroong S, anong gagawin? Pwede nyo tutungan yun eh. Psss, okay? Kasi pag yung sagot nyo, jumps agad, tapos yung sagot nga pala ay jump. Hindi nyo na mababawi pag sumingaw na agad yung S, okay? So, para sa'yo kayo, baka hindi nila kayo i-judge dyan, okay? So, anong lagi nyo sagot? Jump. Pag may S at mga gawin, so, sige, practice ulit tayo. The frog jumps.
Jumps.
Ang S ng iba, jumps. Okay, so, the frogs jumps.
Jump.
O, di ba walang nagkamali? Ang ikantay sa'yo, jump. Pero one word lang naman na S yung nasabi niya. So, hindi pa rin yung mali. Tama pa rin yun, di ba? So, hindi naman natuloy. So, tama yung ginawa ninyo. Pag the frog, ang sagot nyo ay jumps with S dahil isa lang yung frog. Pag the frogs, ang sagot nyo ay jump kasi marami na yung frogs. Basta ganito lang yung rule dyan eh. Di ba may subject tayo, tsaka verb. So, ang ginagawa lang dyan, baliktad lang sila palagi. Okay? Baliktad sila palagi. Pag yung isa may S na, yung isa walang S. Pag yung isa ang walang S, yung isa mayroong S. Basta yung subject at verb ko, ibabaliktad mo lang dapat sila palagi. Isa lang may S, yung isa walang S. Okay? Another rule. All of the pie was or were gone. Okay. Anong nawala? All of the pie. Pie na yun, egg na ngayon. Pie, egg pie. Ganun. So, anong nawala? All of the pie. Ilan yung pie? Isa. Baka pwedeng marami siyang slice, kaya naging all. Pero, isa lang yung pie. So, all of the pie was gone. Okay? All of the pies was or were gone. Anong nawala? All of the pies. Ilan yung pies? Marami. So, all of the pies were gone. So, yung tinitingnan natin dyan, hindi yung all. Kasi pag sinabi natin all, ang dating talaga marami, di ba? Pero ang tinitingnan is yung after the of praise. Ang tinitingnan nyo is yung pie or pies. So, all of the pie was gone. All of the pies were gone. Naintindihan po yung rule? Okay, next one. Everybody. Each, everyone, somebody, nobody, is or are.
Is.
Ano tawag sa mga everybody, each, everyone? Ano sila? Mga indefinite pronouns that takes the singular form of the verb. Pag sinabi natin indefinite, hindi ka sure kung ilan. Pwede isa, dalawa, tatlo, marami. Okay? But may possibility siya na isa lang. So, ang ginagamit natin ay singular, you use is. Okay? But there are indefinite pronouns na sure tayo na more than one siya. Hindi lang natin alam exactly kung ilan sila. For example, few. Pag sinabi ko ba na few, possible na isa lang siya?
No.
Meaning, more than one yun, hindi lang tayo sure kung gaano karami exactly. Pag sinabi kong many, pwede bang isa lang siya?
No.
Pag sinabi kong several, pwede bang isa lang siya?
No.
So, ano ginagamit pa ganun? You use plural, so that is are. Okay? So, now, ulitin natin. Everybody, each, everyone, somebody, nobody?
Is.
Okay? Few, many, several?
Are.
Naintindihan po yung rule? Okay. Next one. Bread and butter is or are?
Is.
A bread and a butter is or are?
Are.
are. So, ganito yun. Yung bread and butter, they are taken as one entity. Meaning, magkasama yung bread at butter. So, ano sagot natin? Is. Pero pag a bread and a butter, tinitingnan dyan yung word na and, okay? Kung pagkatapos ng word na and, may words na a, an, and the. Those are the articles or determiners that will tell you that you have to separate the entity. Pag may words na a, an, and the. Okay, for example, bread and butter is a bread and a butter
are.
Naintindihan yung rule? Fish and rice. Is a fish and a cup of rice?
Are.
Okay, next one. 20 pesos is or are?
Is.
20 miles is or are?
Is.
20 seconds is or are?
Is.
20 seconds for the countdown is or are?
Are.
So, ganito yung rule. Pag measurement, okay, measurement ng time, money, distance. Time, money, distance. Ano yung nagamit dyan? Singular form of the verb. Okay, singular yan palagi. Magiging plural lang siya. May word na countdown. Di ba po nag-countdown ka, binibilang natin isa-isa, bawat minuto, bawat segundo. So they are counted separately, okay? Bawat entity. So ano ginagamit natin doon? Magiging are siya, okay? So ulitin natin. Pag 20 pesos is 20 miles is 20 seconds is 20 seconds for the countdown. Are. Naintindihan po yung rule? Okay, next one. Mathematics, physics, statistics, measles, news, is or are.
Is.
Those are the nouns that ends in S, but singular in form or meaning. Dahil wala namang singular na mathematics, physics, measles, news, statistics. Di ba talagang nag-i-S sila in S, so the answer is. Okay, and those are our basic rules of subject, verb, agreement. Pero sa totoong buhay, sa actual world, kabado ka na dyan, hindi mo na marirecollect sa akin, ala, ano nga rule yung apply ko dito, di ba? Ganyan ang mangyayari sa inyo. So, pag nagkalipitan na, pag hindi nyo maalala kung anong rule ang i-apply, ang technique lang dyan, basahin nyo yung question. Tapos, itry nyo yung option isa-isa. Kung anong masarap pakinggan, that is the correct answer, okay? As usually, pag mali yan, grammatically incorrect siya, awkward siya sa ating pandinig, di ba? So, hindi siya maganda pakinggan. So, kung anong masarap pakinggan, that is the correct answer, okay? Now, tingnan natin yung question. That seems to be the most interesting co-curricular activity of the school year. Oh, try ninyo yung arapiling. Dancing, arapiling, gawin na most interesting. Masarap kayo pakinggan. O doon hindi. Try yung apiling. Dancing, appearing, gawin na most interesting. Masarap kayo pakinggan. Di ba hindi? O anong sagot ninyo? Yung appears. Dancing appears to be the most interesting. Dancing is a gerund used as a subject in the sentence, so that is appears. Okay? Next one. You have identifying errors in academic writing. Hindi kayo mahihirapan dyan sa identifying errors dahil sanay naman kayong maghanap ng mali sa iba, di ba? So, gamitin nyo na lang yung skill na yan sa board exam, okay? Ano ba usually yung mga error na nakakomit natin? So, number one, you have your misplaced modifier. Okay, pag sinabi natin misplaced modifier, mali ang pagkakalagay ng modifier. Yung rule natin, the modifier must be placed near the word it modifies. Okay? Ang modifier nilalagay katabi ng kanyang word na pinomodify. Pag mali yung pagkakalagay mo, anong term doon? Misplaced modifier. For example, faster than a spinning bullet, the citizens of Metropolis saw Superman flying overhead. Sino ang tinutukoy dyan na faster than a spinning bullet? Si Superman. Pero kung babasahin natin yung sentence ng paganyan, sino ang namukhang faster than a spinning bullet? Yung citizens. Bakit? Siya kasi yung katabi ng faster than a spinning bullet. Malayo siya doon kay Superman. So, misplaced modifier yan. Dahil ang sentence dapat ganito. The citizens of Metropolis saw Superman flying overhead faster than a spinning bullet. So, anong tawag doon? Misplaced modifier. Okay, next one, you have your dangling modifier. Ang dangling naman, hindi yung mali ang pagkakalagay, kundi hindi mo talaga nailagay. Okay, hindi mo nailagay kung sino or ano yung kanyang minamodify. So, hindi mo na say clearly if what is being modified. Okay, for example, walking on a sub-zero morning, my left ear became frozen. Sino yung naglalakad?
My!
Yung? My left ear. O, dinalakad yung left ear ngayon, di ba? Kasi hindi mo sinabi kung sino yung naglalakad. Yung sentence dapat ganito. As I was walking on a sub-zero morning, my left ear became frozen. Sino naglalakad? Yung I. So, yan ang tinatawag na dangling. Hindi mo talaga nailagay. Hindi mo na state clearly kung sino yung kanya minamodify. Next one, you have your faulty parallelism. Yan ang pinakamadaling identify sa lahat. Okay? Ano ba ang parallelism? Kailangan the same ang structure within the sentence. Pag positive, positive. Pag negative, negative. Gerund, gerund. Pag noun, noun. For example, popular exercises among men and women includes aerobic dancing, weightlifters, and jogging. What is the error in the sentence?
Weightlifters.
Because that should be weightlifting. ING din dapat siya. So, ang tawag ay faulty parallelism. Okay, next one, you have your comma splice. Ang comma splice, ganito yan. Dalawang sentence na siya. Pilit mo silang pinagsama as one. Separate mo lang using ang comma. Kaya ang haba na ng sentence mo, okay? Dalawang sentence, pinagsama as one, separate lang using a comma. For example, the crowd cheered loudly when the band emerged from the backstage, comma, Eric stood quietly to look. Maganda ba ang sentence? No. Paano pa ganito? The crowd cheered loudly when the band emerged from the backstage. Tuldok. Eric stood quietly. Tuldok. Mas maganda ba ang sentence?
Yes.
Anong error yung nakomment natin dito? Comma splice. Bakit? Dalawang sentence kasi ito. Pinut mo lang sila pinagsama as one. Separate mo lang using a comma. Pero minsan kasi guys, hindi enough yung comma lang. Hindi enough yung tumigil ka lang saglit. May mga bagay na dapat tinutuntukan na tulad ng sentence na yan. Okay? So, always remember, huwag yung ikakama kung may period. Okay? Dapat dyan sa sentence because you are commenting comma splice. Okay? So, anong tawag sa kinaman na may period? Na comma splice. Okay? And last one, you have your fragments. Okay? Pag sinabi fragments, yan yung hindi complete yung kanyang thought kaya nga hindi siya matawag na sentence. For example, the beautiful white cat. Ano nangyari sa cat? Wala, nagmaganda lang siya, di ba? Parang hindi na alam, ano nangyari sa cat? Okay, so it's just a fragment, hindi complete yung kanyang thought, okay? So yan yung mga errors natin sa academic writing. Pero minsan kasi, yung error natin, hindi naman doon sa sentence construction eh. Yung mali talaga natin minsan, yung pagpili lang ng tamang word na gagamitin mo doon sa sentence. Just like your question, blank clothing are advised to be worn during summer. Ang pinag-uusapan natin ay?
Clothing.
Okay. Now, look at the options. Magkakamukha sila, di ba? So, yung problema namin yan sa problem kasi bisaya kami. So, pare-pareho lang din ang pronunciation yan. Loose lang yan, di ba? O, pero para dito kayo magalituhan, okay? Tagalogin na lang natin. Eh, hirap na ako pronounce, okay? Tagalogin na lang natin. Ito muna. Ano sa... Loose. Yan. Ano sa Tagalog? Wala. O, ito. Loose.
Maluwag.
Losing. Nawawala. Lost. Nawala. Now, ano bang gusto niyo mangyari sa gamit ninyo during summer?
Nawala.
Gusto niyo mawala kayong gamit? Maluwag yung inyong gamit? Nawawala yung inyong gamit? Or nawala yung inyong gamit? Siyempre yung gusto natin yung nawawala. Diba? Ano ba dito? Maluwag. Diba? So therefore, the correct answer is loose. Sabi niya, maluwag na gamit. So loose clothing during summer. Okay? Next one, what is concerned about high and low in voice volume and quality? High and low in voice volume and quality. That is your pitch. Di ba yung pitch ay ang highness or lowness ng sound? So that's pitch. And I have here the qualities of sound, okay? As well as the distinction, kung paano nyo sila i-differentiate from each other, okay? For example, sabi nyo kanina, pag high and low, that is your pitch, okay? And then you have duration. Duration meaning yung? Yung haba, yung tagal, di ba? Kung gaano katagal, produce yung sound. So it will either be long or short. Long or short. So that's duration. And the next one you have, intensity. Intensity naman yung lakas. It will either be loud or soft. Okay, loud or soft. So that is intensity. Last season, lumabas yung intensity, pero wala doong intensity sa option. So tingin nyo, ano pwede yung isagot? You can answer volume. Yes, pag wala intensity, you answer volume. It is still the loudness or the softness of sound. Okay? And then you have timbre. Kung sinabing timbre, yan yung distinct sound na naririnig nyo. Pwede yung naririnig mong timbre, boses, pwede yung naririnig mo ay instrument. So it will either be a voice or an instrument. Now, sabihin nyo lang sa akin kung ano ang dinidescribe ko. High and low?
Three.
Long and short?
Three.
Loud and soft?
Three.
Voices, instrument?
Three.
Loud and soft?
Three.
High and low?
Three.
Long and short?
Three.
Voices, instrument?
Three.
Loud and soft? Voices, instrument? High and low? Long and short? Loud and soft? Sabi niyo ba? Naduling-guling na sa kapataas baba, as baba. Okay. Now, ang tiyan naman naman sa inyo, high and low, diba? So, anong tama sagot? That is your pitch. Okay? And last number, the show phonological awareness skill of lang, the students are asked to add, delete, and substitute a sound or a syllable. Are you familiar with phonological awareness skill? So, yan ay sa leadership na actually ng English lumalabas, ang phonological awareness skill. Pero nagiging trend yung lately sa PEF dahil importante sa inyo yan. Di ba yung mga elementary teachers, kayo yung natuturo sa bata paano magbasa, di ba? At ang phonological awareness skill, yan yung kauna-unahang skill na kailangan matutunan ng bata before siya matutong magbasa. Yan yung inaalam niya yung tunog, yung phonemes, okay, yung bawat tunog ng letra. Naalala niyo kung ano? Nung ritual tayo, ano yung activity natin? Di ba may flashcard, tapos may letter, tapos buong araw, yan lang. Ano classroom sa grade 1, sabay-sabay yan, di ba? Anong ginagawa ng mga bata? Buong araw yan, puro ganyan. Kasi nga, inaalam natin yung bawat letters. Okay, ano ba yung tunog nila? So, pag marunong ka na nun, so pwede ka nang matutong magbasa. Now, mayroon tayong anim na skills dyan. Mayroon basic skills ng phonological awareness. Number one, yung listening. Okay, ganito lang yan. Ang listening, inaalam lang ng teacher kung kaya ng bata i-identify if the same yung sound. Okay, i-identify if the same yung sound. Halimbawa, cat, cat, the same ba yung sound? Yes, okay. Cat, car, the same ba yung sound? No. So meaning, mayroon kayong listening skill. Kasi kaya nyo sabihin sa akin kung the same or hindi yung sound. Okay, so pag inaalam lang ng teacher, and the same yung sound, ang tawag doon ay listening. Pero minsan, mas particular na sound yung hinihingi niya. Pag inaalam ng teacher, if the same yung beginning sound, ang tawag ay alliteration. Okay, pag beginning sound, anong tawag? Alliteration. Di ba kahit sa ating rhetorical device, ano nga ang alliteration? The repetition of the initial consonant sound. So, nasaan yung pare-pareho na sound? Doon sa initial, sa unahan. So, pag inaalam ng teacher, if the same yung keyword nyo is beginning sound, ang tawag ay alliteration. Halimbawa, hop, happy. Hop, happy. The same pa sila ng beginning sound?
Yes.
Yes. So, meaning mayroon na rin kayong skill sa alliteration. Pero paano pag ang inaalam niya is yung dulo. Ano kaya yung dulo? Rhyming. Saan ba nandito yung rhyme? Doon sa dulo. So, pag inaalam niya, if the same yung ending sound, ang tawag naman ay rhyming. Just like your boy, toy. Boy, toy. So, pag ending sound naman, ano tawag? Rhyming. Nakuha po ang difference. Okay. Ano yung inaalam ng teacher if the same yung sound? The same lang yung sound?
Listening.
Pag the same yung beginning sound? Alliteration. The same yung ending sound? Rhyming. Okay. Next one yung blending and segmentation or segmenting. Blending, segmenting, blending, segmenting. Okay. Magkabaliktaran silang dalawa. Sa blending, ganito yung gagawin ko. Sasabihin mo muna isa-isa yung sound, tapos i-combine mo siya, i-blend mo siya to form the word. For example, C is, A is, T is, sa pag-blend niyo yun, ano nabuo nating word? It's cat. Ano tawag doon? Blending. Sinabi muna natin yung sound, tapos kinumbine, blended to form the word. That's blending, okay? Baliktarin mo yun, at tawag ay segmenting. As segmenting, sasabihin mo muna yung word, tapos ika-cut mo siya, isi-segment mo siya into sounds, okay? Ano yung halimbawa? You have the word cat. Ano yung mga sounds ng cat? C is, A is, T is, so anong ginawa natin? Segmenting. Binigay ko muna yung word, tapos kinap ko siya into sound. So that's segmenting. Nakuha ang difference ng dalawa? O, ganito. Sabihin ko muna yung sound, tapos i-combine ko siya to form the word. Anong tawag?
Blending.
Sabihin ko muna yung word, tapos i-cut ko siya to form the sounds. Anong tawag? Segmenting. Okay, nakuha ko ang difference. Balikton kasi ng dalawa, ha? Okay, and the last one is your syllabication. So, syllabication, inaalam mo lang ilang syllables ang mayroon. For example, waiter. Ilang syllables?
Two.
Okay, licensure. Licensure. And three. Examination. Examination. Ilan? Five. So, meaning, marunong mo rin kayo ng syllabification. Sige, ulit ko lang natin ang inyong phonological awareness skill. Ano yung inaalam ng teacher if the same yung sound?
Listening.
Yung beginning sound? Alliteration. Yung ending sound? Rhyming. Sabihin ko muna yung sound, tapos i-combine to form the word. Blending. Sabihin ko muna yung word, tapos i-cut ko siya into sounds. Segmenting. Inaalam natin kung ilang syllables? Syllabication. Or syllables. Okay. Now, let's answer the question. The students are asked to add, delete, and substitute. Nag-add, nag-delete, nag-substitute. Blending ba yun?
No.
No. Segmenting ba yun?
No.
No. Rhyming ba yun?
No.
Actually, wala siya doon sa binanggit natin kasi mas malalim yung ginawa niya. Nag-add, delete, nag-substitute. Anong ginawa niya? Pinakaalaman niya talaga yung buong word. So, ano nang tawag natin doon? That is your modification. So, although hindi na masyadong dinidiscuss ang modification, makahanap niyo pa rin na siya ang tamang sagot. So, that's letter B. And you count the number of correct answer for English. That's number 1 to 10.